This video will show you how to pass the second part of the relative pronoun CP. You will have a sentence in English, and you're going to have to identify the relative pronoun and give its case, number, and gender. The relative pronoun in this sentence is to whom. To whom is always dative. And now to figure out the number and the gender, I have to look at the antecedent. The antecedent is boy, which is singular and masculine. So I click all the boxes that apply. The next question is, the woman whose husbands were in battle were scared. The relative pronoun is whose, which is always genitive. I look back at the antecedent women, which is plural and feminine. I go back, and I find the relative pronoun is which. So Athena and jealousy personify could not find any flaw in the work which was made by Arachne. So we have come to the which is which problem for the pronouns. And remember the trick. If it's which immediately followed by a verb, it's going to be nominative. If it's which followed by anything but a verb, a non-verb, it will be accusative. In this case, was is a verb, this is going to be nominative. I go back and I look at work. Work is singular, and I even give it to you as neuter, so I click the neuter box. Little Cicero loves his sister, who also loves him. Who is always nominative. I look at the antecedent, which is sister, which is singular and feminine, so I check the boxes. Poseidon, whose weapon is the trident, struck the Acropolis of Athens, and a salt spring sprung forth. Whose is always genitive. I look back at Poseidon, it is singular, and Poseidon is masculine. Athena's tapestry showed the glory of the 12 gods, whose home is lofty Olympus. Whose, again, is always genitive. Goes back to gods, which are plural and masculine. And this is how you pass the second part of the relative pronoun CP.